Welcome to the Real Outdoor Experience series on goose hunting for beginners. This series is brought to you by Mossberg Firearms, Kent Cartridge, Altan Safe Outdoors, and Steel Shot Guide Service. Now let's get to it.
Hi everybody, it's Carlin and Ian from the Real Outdoor Experience. Thanks for tuning in to episode one. This episode is all about landowner permission, licenses, and things like the migratory bird stamp from the federal government. Mm-hmm. It's all very confusing sometimes. Where do we start?
Like anything else, you really need to be able to hunt where the birds are. And it's difficult with birds because you never know from one day to the next exactly where they're going to land. Like turkeys and deer will tend to stay on the same farm. So if you can get permission on that farm, chances are pretty good that you've got a spot to hunt all the time. But with geese, they could be hitting one field one day, and because they're migratory, you know, that flock of geese is going to be gone the next day.
Right.
And where's that next flock of geese coming from? They could be just two farms over. The magic of goose hunting is being able to get permission on a wide range of farms.
So having one property like we do here for deer, for turkeys, not going to cut it for waterfowl because of their nomadic nature, because of the food resources, and because, you know, like you said, here they are today but gone tomorrow. One of the things that we talk to people frequently about is how to get landowner permission. And really, the farmers, a lot of them have had both good and bad experiences. So us as hunters, and especially as a new hunter, you want to get as many permissions as possible to give you options. I often suggest to people the OFAH permission form where the hunter and the farmer sign it. Being a member of that organization gives you the insurance, mm-hmm. which gives a farmer a little bit of peace of mind because, you know, let's face it, liability is a big issue today to a lot of people.
Yep.
So if you show up at their door and you're just some guy that you've, you know, never met before, asking for permission to hunt, and that's as far as the conversation goes, expect to hear a no. But if you present yourself in a professional manner with a document that, you know, gives them a little bit of peace of mind, I think they're more to consider you than not.
Something else that's, I think, really beneficial are, frankly, letters of reference.
Yeah.
The farming community is relatively tight, and farmers have, generally speaking, been around forever. And if you've got something from Farmer McDonald that says, you know, Carl and Ian are really great guys, they're conscientious, they're clean up after them, they help me do my hay, they'll help me split firewood, whatever we want to do to get permission, I think that that will go a long way. And I think finding out what's important to them, you know, whether it is, you know, helping them out for a day doing firewood or bringing them maybe a bottle of scotch at the end of
Absolutely.
The season or some meat if that's what they want. But you know, giving back is important. If they give you access, give something back. It's important and will help future generations of hunters because they'll have a positive experience with you.
We hunt with a lot of people from Go Hunt Birds, and some of those dudes are absolute hardcore guys, and they need a tandem axle trailer to bring all their gear out. Whereas if you can't drive that in, that is a different day. That's going to be
yep.
a different setup.
Yep.
So talk to the farmer up front, know exactly what both sides' expectations are. So obviously when we're hunting anything, we need to check into the appropriate licensing. So we're gonna refer you to the rules and regs. But with migratory birds, you also need to get a stamp. And those are sold at the post office. And every hunter, regardless if you are an apprentice or the licensed hunter, every hunter needs a stamp.
And that's a federal license.
It is a federal license.
That is not that's not part of a provincial thing. But your stamp is also good in, well, here in Quebec or in Ontario.
Right. But it's a little bit confusing because with the apprenticeship thing, if I'm the hunter and you're the apprentice, we share limits.
Right.
But with migratory birds, you buy a tag, you buy the federal seal, I buy the federal seal. We can only have one gun, but we both get our own limit. So it's the only one that works that way, just a little bit different, just so you're aware. And that can be found in the Ontario regs. Goose and duck hunting, there's just so much action that it is a great place for apprentice hunters. If you started your apprentice out turkey hunting, as much fun as that is, and don't get me wrong, I love turkey hunting, but sitting there all season and seeing birds but never having that opportunity, that's a little bit, I don't know if you're setting them up for a fail or not. It really depends on the kid. But goose hunting, it's action.
It's a great place to start because the action is plentiful and there's
Absolutely.
An expectation of, you know, seeing birds and hearing stuff and you know, getting shot.
So. Yeah, lots of fun. Well, thanks folks. That's it for episode one. Stay tuned for episode two.
Thanks everybody. As always, keep it real.
Thanks for watching. Take care for now.